baby, baby me. Little baby, baby me. In my heart, you are the one.
On February 3rd, 1936, Ella and Lawrence Hawley had their fourth child and third son in their home in Lubbock, Texas. His birth name was Charles Hardin Hawley, spelled H-O-L-L-E-Y. He would later drop the E from his name.
No, it's a boy, you idiot! Let's call him Charles Hardin. Because he's tiny. Funny. Oh, baby.
Ella and Lawrence Hawley were very strong Baptists, so they had Buddy baptize his toddler at the Tabernacle Baptist Church.
The Son and the Holy Spirit in the Holy Baptist Church.
In 1943, Buddy entered first grade at Roscoe Wilson Elementary. He soon found he didn't have the need to study because he got straight A's without trying.
Buddy was just naturally smart. He always was distracted in class, but he got good grades nevertheless.
In 1944, Buddy spent the summer horseback riding, hunting, and fishing in his Uncle Judd's farm with his cousin Sam Modrill. Buddy's older brothers were both musical. One played the violin, the other played the accordion.
In 1945, Buddy's brother Travis came home from World War II, brought his guitar, and taught Buddy how to play.
In 1946, the Hawley family moved outside the Lubbock city limits to less expensive walk-in addition.
In 1949, the family moved back into the city of Lubbock, and Buddy attended J.T. Hutchinson Junior High School. There he met Bob Montgomery, and they played together for school talent shows and parties. In 1955, after Buddy and Bob graduated high school, they created a radio station called The Buddy and Bob Show that played at Lubbock's KDAV radio station. Same year, Buddy opened for Elvis Presley, where soon Elvis became his idol. Buddy previously played songs from his country western genre, but after he met Elvis, he switched to rock and roll. His music included rock and roll styles with swing and jazz incorporated. But Buddy was famous for his unique voice hiccup. Audience loved Buddy and his music, but he did not have the same sex appeal as Elvis.
In 1956, Buddy was signed to Decca Records after being scouted at a talent show. Buddy and his friends, now called Buddy Hawley and the Three Tunes, recorded in Nashville. After their first record came out, Buddy's name was misspelled, so he dropped the E.
In early 1957, Nicky Sullivan left the group because he found the schedule too tough to handle. The band decided to change their name. Its nicknames were the fad at the time. They thought about many different names and even considered the Beatles, but decided on the Crickets because there were many Crickets in Texas that year, and they thought that would be appropriate.
I'm out of here, guys! You only will
change our names.
Well, that'll be the day when you say goodbye. Yes, that'll be the day.
On February 25th, 1957, Buddy Hawley and the Crickets recorded That'll Be the Day in Clovis, New Mexico. The name came from a film by John Wayne called The Searchers. The song later became a number one top hit and won them a contract with Coral and Brunswick. In March of 1958, Buddy and the Crickets started a 25-day tour in England, which was where the Beatles and the Rolling Stones were inspired by Buddy. Later, the Beatles would name themselves after the Crickets.
When you say goodbye, yes, that'll be the day.
Buddy Hawley gave him confidence. He was like the boy next door. You know it's a lie,
cause that'll be the day. One summer, I remember, I got exposed to Chuck Berry and Buddy Hawley. And Buddy Hawley was very, very big. Made a very big impression on me. Because a lot of things, you know, than he looked and his charisma.
Between August of 1957 and August of 1958, Buddy and the Crickets had 7 hits in the top 40 singles, including That'll Be the Day, Peggy Sue, Maybe Baby, Oh Boy, and Rave On.
Now we have some young singers who are creating a great deal of excitement in the Paramount Theater here in New York. Now, if you haven't heard of these young men, then you must be the wrong age, because they're rock and roll specialists. Now, no matter what you think of rock and roll, I think you have to keep a nice open mind about what the young people go for. Otherwise, the youngsters won't feel that you understand them. Now, if we're ready for our rock and roll specialist, we have Buddy Holly and the Crickets.
One day, Buddy walked to the desk of the receptionist of Decca Studio and asked her on a date.
Are your feet hurting? Because you've been running through my mind all day. You got the setting.
Okay, babe.
Buddy proposed to her on their first date, and they were married 1 month later.
Buddy married Maria Elena Santiago at his parents' house. On October 19, 1958, Buddy Holly and the Crickets split up. Buddy even appeared on the Ed Sullivan Show.
Like you said, you don't know what you've been missing, oh boy. When you're with me, oh boy, I thought the world could say that you were a bitch for me. All my life I've been waiting, and I there'll be no hesitating, oh boy. When you're with me, oh boy, I thought the world could say that you were a bitch for me. Stars appear and the shadows are falling. You can hear my heart calling. A little bit of love, it makes everything right. I'm gonna see my baby tonight. All of my love, all of my kissing. You don't know what you've been missing, oh boy. When you're with me, oh boy, I thought the world could say that you were missing for me.
The Midwest Winter Dance Party started on January 27th, 1959. Buddy did not want to do this tour, but he needed the money after the band split up. Joining Buddy on tour was Richie Valens and the Big Bopper. Buddy and his band members, Alsup and Jennings, were supposed to go on the plane. Jennings gave up his seat to the Big Bopper because he was sick, and Valens won a coin toss with Alsup for his seat.
I hope your damn bus freezes up. I hope your whole plane crashes.
Buddy's plane left Mason City Airport in Iowa at 1 a.m. The plane crashed in a cornfield a few minutes later. The crash killed everyone on board. Buddy Holly was thrown 20 yards from the plane.
We'll buy and buy. No truth.
Buddy died on February 3rd, 1959, at only 22 years old.
Sometimes we'll sigh.
We were sitting on a porch one day when Buddy laughed and told me that death is often referred to as a good career move. I had no idea that that would be the last I spoke with him.
After Buddy's death, his funeral was held a few weeks later at Tabernacle Baptist Church, the same place he was baptized. Maria, his wife, did not attend the funeral because she had just suffered a miscarriage after only 2 weeks of pregnancy. Maria later married Joe Diaz. Bobby V replaced Buddy on the Winter Dance Party. Then Frankie Avalon, Jimmy Clanton, and Fabian were hired to finish out the tour in place of the three headliners who were killed in the plane crash.
Sometimes
1959, Buddy Holly, I saw him live. Incredible, so incredible, blew my mind away. The way he played that guitar, oh my God, made me weep, made me cry. That's what changed my life.
A while after their deaths, the musician Don McLean wrote the song American Pie, which commemorated the deaths of Buddy Holly, the Big Bopper, and Ricky Valens. The song hailed Buddy's death as the day the music died because of Holly's incredible influence in the world of rock and roll.
Long, long time ago, I can still remember how that music used to make me smile. And I knew if I had my chance that I could make those people dance, and maybe they'd be happy for a while. But February made me shiver with every paper I'd deliver. Bad news on the doorstep. I couldn't take one more step. I can't remember if I cried when I read about his widowed bride. But something touched me deep inside the day the music died.
Buddy was ranked number 13 in the 100 Greatest Artists of All Time poll in Rolling Stone magazine. He had many top 40 hits, and his songs touched the hearts of many people. Fans can still visit the crash site in Iowa in addition to his grave site in Lubbock.
Hey, 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 every day it's getting faster.
Not only was Buddy Holly's guitar famous, but fellow cricket Waylon Jennings went on to be a great country success. In 1978, actor Gary Busey starred as Buddy Holly in The Buddy Holly Story.
Make me want hope to be with you. Red bone is a crazy feeling, and I know it's got me reeling when you say you love me, just way my heart. The way you dance and hold me tight.
When they gave me that permanent and put those glasses on me and darkened my hair and gave me those dorky looking clothes from the 50s, I could not find Gary Busey in the mirror. I wasn't there to think. I wasn't there to indicate. I wasn't there to prepare a plan. I was just truthfully me. And I heard the stories from Buddy Holly, and I remember in the ninth grade, I was standing in my front room, 7410 East 3rd Street in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Heard on the radio, remember right where I was standing, right where I was looking. I remember everything around me. And Buddy Holly, Richie Valens, and the Big Bopper were dead. They went down the plane. First thing I thought, we'll never hear that music again. We'll never hear that music again. We won't hear Peggy Sue. We won't hear Every Day. We won't hear That'll Be the Day. We won't hear Oh Boy. But lo and behold, he picked me to play Buddy Holly. I did it. Now the music is heard again. It'll be heard again. It'll be heard again. That is the biggest moment of my life in this career I've had making pictures. 33 years, 105 movies. That one, that was a big one. That was the biggest one.
Buddy Holly's death will forever be remembered as the day the music died. His death was a tragic loss to the world of music. He influenced many young aspiring musicians, including the Rolling Stones, Bob Dylan, and the Beatles. The whole nation grieved after Buddy Holly's death.
Getting faster, everyone said go ahead and ask her. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, hey, hey. Every day seems a little longer. Every way love's a little stronger. Come what may, do you ever long for true love from me? Every day it's a getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way.